Hello, and welcome to Chamber Chat. I'm your host, Vicki Fetters Delfino. My first guest today is Jean Love. Hi, Jean.
Hi, Vicki.
How are you?
I'm great. How are you doing?
I'm doing really well. Is it weird for you to be in this chair instead of mine?
I like it better on this side.
And for those of you that don't know, Jean, in a past lifetime,
yes.
was the executive director of the Monmouth Independence Chamber, and she started Chamber Chat.
With a collection of some help of others, yes. And I sat there and monthly, happily, discussed items with people. And,
Chamber chatted it away.
Yes, and now it's nice to be on this side.
So tell me why you're here today, Jean. What are we talking about?
Well, I have the opportunity today, and thank you for this opportunity,
of course.
To talk about the Thoughts and Gifts Project. The Thoughts and Gifts Project is, you could call it my baby, if you will, my dream. We are a 501c3 public charity, so we're mm-hmm. a nonprofit. Mm-hmm. We opened our doors in June of last year, so
wow.
we're not even a year old. And we have the mission to celebrate the value and importance of low-income youth ages 0 to 18 mm-hmm. and seniors 65 and older. Mm-hmm. That is our mission statement. Mm-hmm. We do that through a program that has four components. Mm-hmm. The first part is each recipient can receive a gift or gifts with a maximum value of $30. We include a birthday card with a personalized message from us, as well as some blank cards for family or friends to also leave a personal note.
That.
We also have, we provide an age-appropriate and level-appropriate book, because we want to encourage mm-hmm. literacy. Mm-hmm. And then to complete the birthday experience, once a month, we have a monthly birthday party, and all of our recipients are invited to attend. That way there's
wonderful.
Games and food, get a cupcake with a candle, make a wish, and to have, again, that full birthday experience.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's what we do at the Thoughts and Gifts Project.
So how was your first birthday party that you threw?
Yeah,
how was it?
It was fun. Definitely a little bit of a learning curve. Everyone who was there, we had several youth recipients mm-hmm. as well as we had a senior recipient. Mm-hmm. There were food games we played. Wow. Instead of Pin the Tail on the Donkey, we mm-hmm. have a pin the candle on the cake.
Oh, I love that.
Yes, thanks to Kevin at Main Street Tattoo. He designed a board for us and whatnot.
That's so sweet.
So we did that, and we had Toss Across, which I hadn't played in a long time. We played bingo. There was mm-hmm. lots of food. It was all fun,
okay.
and it was a really good time. So we actually, today is Thursday, mm-hmm. and we have our next party coming up this Sunday
wow.
on February 10th.
How exciting.
As long as the weather holds out. So yeah, we'll have another one, but the goal is to do one each month, as mm-hmm. long as obviously we have the participants who are able to
right.
be there.
For everybody whose birthday
exactly.
it is.
Exactly.
That month, that's awesome. And how do people sign up to participate?
It's similar. A lot of people are familiar with Toys for Tots or Angel mm-hmm. Tree or outreach programs like that around mm-hmm. the Christmas holiday season. We also have an application that needs to be completed on site. Mm-hmm. We are located on 3rd Street in Independence. It's the historic Independence Women's Club building. Now known as the Polk County Service Club. Mm-hmm. We are there Tuesdays, Wednesdays, and Thursdays from 12 until 6. And we do have an on-site application for a youth recipient. We do ask that the primary parent or guardian completes the application. Mm-hmm. And for a senior, the senior may self-identify and complete the application or be referred by a friend. And then
cool.
that way we have a chance to talk to that person to mm-hmm. understand more of what the person wants as the gift or gifts should be, mm-hmm. To get to know types of books that might be appropriate. And that way it is yeah. more of a personalized.
Absolutely. It feels like it's for that person.
Exactly. And not just
generic.
A generic. Exactly.
Yeah. You don't want to give the Da Vinci Code to everybody.
Right, yeah. right, right.
Totally understand.
Right. And we do have the caveat of we are not responsible for content within said books.
I was going to ask about that.
Right.
That's awesome. Has there been a gift that one of your participants received, like a moment of those that really stuck out to you?
I've really been, I think it was two of the first three recipients that we had last year mm-hmm. Were for teenagers. Mm-hmm. And two of those three recipients specifically wanted books as the birthday present.
Oh, wow.
Which I
That's
thought
awesome.
Was really cool.
Yeah.
Of all the things you could
yeah.
want at any age.
But, to read
but
is
they
amazing.
Specifically, they wanted books. And so not only did they get the books as part of their gifts, but then we also give a book. And so, here you have some books.
Oh, yay. So,
yeah.
That's
so
awesome.
Lots of reading pleasure.
Oh, good. That's my favorite. English major. I can't
right, there you
it.
Go.
So just kind of to get some history on you. So how long have you been in Monmouth Independence?
I officially moved to this area in March of 2011. So I have an 8-year anniversary coming up.
Wow.
I know it's been a while. And originally my husband worked at Western Oregon University and with the foundation. Mm-hmm. And I started the chamber job actually in 2012. Mm-hmm. So we've been here for a while, and my husband now works at OSU, also doing fundraising, and I have the Thoughts and Gifts Project. So, but we have made this community our home.
Yeah.
It's definitely where our hearts are, and one of the reasons that I started the nonprofit, because this community is fantastic, and mm-hmm. we're just really happy to be here.
Mm-hmm. And one of the things I've noticed about Monmouth Independence is we have a plethora of people who want to help and volunteer and help out. Have you had experience or lots of people dying to help you out?
Had a lot of different opportunities. This past summer at the Independence Riverview Farmers Market, we mm-hmm. had an information booth there. We've gone to some other places to have an information booth. There's the back school bash that we did for Central School.
Oh, you guys look like you're having such a good time.
It was great. Lots of young ones, backpacks, food, and fun. But we've had the opportunity to really engage as often as we can with the community. Mm-hmm. And it's not uncommon for people to say, hey, how can I help? What can mm-hmm. I do? We do have a volunteer application process. We do want volunteers to be 18 or older. Mm-hmm. We have different insurance policies that require we do certain levels. So we actually do have our volunteers do a criminal history check. Because we work with vulnerable populations,
kids,
exactly,
yeah.
and the seniors.
And the seniors, yeah.
And then because you typically drive your personal car, we also do a driving record.
Oh, makes sense.
To make sure that, again, our insurance is okay with you driving on our behalf.
Absolutely.
So it's a little more than just, hey, what can I do to help out? Right. We do have a little more of a process in place, but it's also for the betterment of the organization, of the clients, and obviously of the volunteers.
Just keeping everybody safe and happy.
Yep, exactly.
I get it. I do. And can people donate? Books
absolutely.
Or prizes or money?
Donations of all. We are a 501c3, so as a public charity, donations are tax deductible if you choose to do your tax deductions. We do accept, obviously, monetary donations. We have an online ability on our website for people to donate directly with the debit or credit card. Mm-hmm. Obviously, cash and checks mm-hmm. will work very well, too. But we also take donated items. All items must be new. We mm-hmm. do want the gifts to be new, not that repurposed items are bad.
Right.
But we do want new items for our clients. Sure. Books can be gently used.
Makes sense.
Books, yeah, they have such a great longevity.
But if it's a stuffed animal, you don't know if there's allergens. Or...
Exactly. So we don't accept clothing. We don't accept stuffed animals, weapons. There's a list on our website of things we don't take, but the main ones, because like you said with stuffed animals, they're hard to track.
Yeah, absolutely.
And you don't know where the stuffed animal's been, and the child or the senior who gets it.
Yeah, I totally get it.
We have some limitations.
Yeah. Vulnerable populations.
Exactly.
You got to protect them. Yeah. I get it. I know I already talked about kind of this activity and volunteerism and like drive to participate, but what stuck out to you about Monmouth and Independence when you first came here?
Just if you want to be involved, if you want to be engaged in your community, there are definitely different components, avenues to mm-hmm. do it.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not hard to find those avenues.
Right.
The Chamber of Commerce obviously offers a lot of great networking mm-hmm. opportunities, and you can go there even... you know, and just introduce yourself and meet people and then find your path. We have two very active libraries in our community.
We really do.
Western Oregon has a lot of different opportunities for people. Mm-hmm. The two cities have different opportunities for people. So if you want to be involved and engaged, plus there's all these other service providers.
Yeah.
There's a Rotary Club, there's a Central Lions Club, there's Masons. Yeah. I mean, there's all of those. And so if you want something to do, there's definitely ways to be involved if you want them.
Awesome. Well, is there anything coming up soon besides this birthday party that you want folks to be aware of?
Well, yes, there is.
Uh-huh.
So we, as a new nonprofit in our community, we are hosting our inaugural, what we are calling a Very Merry Unbirthday Party.
Oh, I
and
love it.
And there you go. The save the date. It will be on Friday, April 12th. We will open the doors at 7:30 at Eola Hills. This is a fun unbirthday party, unless it's your birthday on April 12th, and then we'll call it your birthday
party.
Well,
how convenient.
But we're going to have a tasting adventure for participants. It'll be $25. Registration will open up later this month.
Fun.
We'll have online registration at our website.
Awesome.
But it'll be a tasting adventure for those who like wine. It'll be some wine tasting with paired food bites.
Oh, fun.
And for people who don't like wine, we also have an alternative for you, so that's okay. We want to please all.
Oh, I love it.
We'll also have some fun, calling them quirky games.
Ooh.
So that people can have that party experience, you know, adults having some fun.
Sure.
We'll do a short program, and really it's just the idea of, for if you're not familiar, the unbirthday party comes from Alice in Wonderland, and that you have a birthday one day a year, but you have 364 unbirthdays. So we just want people to come, enjoy, celebrate. It's a fundraiser for us. We are calling it a fun, F-U-N,
raiser.
And yeah, it's our first one, and we're excited. I will say one of the quirky games to do a hole-in-one, but instead of using a golf putter, use a yard flamingo.
Oh, my God. Oh, my gosh, like the Queen of
Hearts. There you go.
Oh, okay, I get it. I love it.
So we definitely are trying to find some fun, quirky, and just activities for the adults to play.
Yeah.
And, yeah, so check it out. We'll again, the online registration will be available this month. The event on Friday, April 12th.
Awesome. Well, thank you, Jean, for taking the time out of your Thursday to come and talk to us today.
And just real quick, we do have a Facebook page. People are welcome to like us there and share posts that you find exciting. Our website, of course, thoughtsandgifts.org. I did not make it clear, but those that we serve, as long as someone is eligible for federal assistance, so that could be free reduced lunch, SNAP, TANF, Medicaid, any of those types of federal assistance programs, as long as the youth or the senior is eligible, then they qualify for us. We do not ask for proof of need, so we're not asking for tax records or anything of that nature, but if you tell me that you qualify, then let's get the application completed and a birthday celebrated.
So it's even like an honor system kind
of very much so.
Love that, because that suits us well, I think.
Yes, very informal and just really here to help and make sure that people are recognized on their birthdays.
Oh, I love that.
Thank you.
And in case you guys didn't know, Jean's nonprofit, the Thoughts and Gifts Project, is a nominee finalist for our 54th Annual Community Awards Banquet. So if you would like more information on how you can participate in the banquet or vote for Jean, I will give you guys all of that information in our next little segment. But I just wanted to say thank you, Jean, for taking the time and doing such a great job with the chamber and with this new project.
Well, thank you very much. This is fun being here again on this side. You're doing a great job yourself, and just thank you for everything.
All right, and stay tuned. We'll give you all that awards banquet information when we come back. Welcome back to Chamber Chat. I just wanted to take a moment really quickly today to let you guys know about some upcoming deadlines for the 54th Annual Community Awards Banquet happening March 8th, which is a Friday, at Western Oregon University. Our first deadline I wanted to highlight is our sponsorship deadline. The deadline for sponsorship is February 15th, which is 1 week before the ticket deadline of February 22nd. If you would like to participate but don't want to sign up for a sponsorship or aren't able to attend the event, but you'd still like to get your marketing information out there for your business or organization, a great way to do that is donating a prize for our raffle we'll have at our event. You can even put marketing materials for your company in there. If you have any branded materials like cups or water bottles that you wanted to incorporate into a gift basket for a prize, that would be wonderful. All that we ask is that it's at least $10 in value and that you get it to us by March 1st, a week before the event. If you would like to vote in our second round of voting, which will be open until February 22nd, you can find it at our website, which is www.micc-or.org. You can also give us a call at 503-838-4268 with any questions about the awards banquet or to schedule your own guest segment on Chamber Chat. Until next time, I'm your host, Vicki Fetters-Delfino. Thank you so much for watching.